Which, like, I'm not upset about nothing because ain't nothing in my father's gate. And if it was, he man enough to put that on the table. This is what I do. Who going to say something? Who going to check it? Nah, that ain't the situation. And, one thing you said, man, you said we all knew about this. I got dudes older than my father that burnt him out the house. That's like, what this nigga saying? Oh, he tripping. He saying some shit, man, nigga ain't never thought about. Because the thing about Pop is he all the way, man. Whatever he do, he don't have from that. And he definitely wouldn't have, you know what I mean? That wouldn't have been a situation he had from, because he's mad. And back then, you had men that was on that. I mean, actually, he just come home not so long ago, so he just come home from men that's on it. And this would let me know he was on some crazy things a long time ago. I read his book, and I said, dang, I ain't read the book. I opened it up and read the name. I ain't see my father's name, so I read it again, and I read it again. I said, this the same dude he saved his life before. Mm-hmm. We even saved this guy's life in jail before. And not because he was our friend, none of that, because he was a friend of a friend of ours, and dudes come to kill him, and Pop got in the middle. These niggas got their knives out. What y'all doing? Oh, son, you got, what y'all doing? Oh, nah, son, all right, put them down, we're going to talk on this. And your life got spared from a talk. They was coming with knives to put in you. Pop stepped in front of you, put you behind him on his hip. What y'all doing? Nah, what you oh, put that shit down, we're going to talk. Y'all was out there shooting guns. Let me tell you something I done learned in life from Pop being in jail 30 years. Right. I ain't got over shooting a gun. My word, my opinion, my ability to be here to know what's going on is stronger than all that shit. Because only, you know, you only a fool if you let these niggas trick you into that. So, you know, dudes like Pop and that reality and that status, they kind of took their losses for a nigga like me.
Right.
I'm a son of all them dudes, you know, because I come from that caliber, and I come from that, like, it's great man time. However it go, up, down, over, left, whatever, man, be man and stand on your tent, and nothing else. You know, so this situation right here is, you know, it's so many different levels of gone to the left, because one thing, you can say you see what you seen, but that's something you pulled a stamp to him and smacked him in his face or whatever, like you say, man, smack that nigga in the face, tell him you don't fuck with a master mate. You know, and it's just too much to try to make yourself like the streets don't know that Pop ran this motherfucker. And I ain't saying it because he's my father. This is his town. He ran it. His profession was murder. Like, it wasn't no hustling or pimping. He was a murderer. So, like, that's where it lies at with the fear and the power and all the things that go under that. It all came behind that. Because however it went, he snapped that Frankie, pressed that button.
I think you're going to bed. I did feel one thing that he said. I mean, I was hurt that it happened, but, you know, you always hurt by a situation when you hear it. And when I heard him confess to it, he said, listen, out of everything I've done, the thing that bothered me the most is me killing my child's mother.
Okay. So that situation.
But he leans on the end on that, and he speaks of his sorrow and his forgiveness of him being a Muslim man and saying, look, that was wrong. And I honored that. He was a man's
for
speaking up and saying, damn, I fucked up. You know what I mean?
Right, period, yeah. And what it was, he should have took more time to look into that situation before he sent time to do that work.
Right.
Yeah. But Mike, he was that type of dude, you know.
He wasn't giving him a chance.
Real conniving and real sneaky, you know what I'm saying?
Right. He wasn't gonna allow someone to come in that courtroom morning.
Nah.
And that person was breathing. Nah. And we understand that, right? My thing is this with the children. And that's why I speak on it with Wayne Perry, because he expressed his forgiveness. The youngest out
right,
in
that's
this
what
era, now listen, the youngest in this era, they don't care about that. So we got
to that's what they need to know.
So they stop.
See, Pop need to be set as an example for these youngers to know, like, listen, not telling you what to do, not trying to, you know, say go this way, but I'm going to show you some example of things and give you some reality of things that if you pay attention to them good enough, it might give you a better thought and a better direction of things you do and how to do them. You know what I'm saying? So that's what he is an example for. By him standing up, by him being the man he is, yeah, fuck the killing. Let's talk about standing up on. Let's talk about when getting to them that. Like, so we can stop them from getting in that situation so they have to do that. So that's the whole big scenario around all of it. And that's what Slim should be, because he working with the youngin. Don't try to bring another man down to build yourself up.
Right. That's just what I know about him. I've seen him even with Lil' Haleem Flowers, because we was in the same can at the time together, or whatever the case
was. Yeah, good man.
And I seen that they was like in the same kind of article, and he was coming from ADX though, your pop. And your pop was speaking on a whole bunch of positive stuff, man. And so many dudes try to bring you down. I'm a Muslim first. And in Islam, it teaches me about the man that killed 99 people and then turned around and killed the one. And Allah, he was seeking for forgiveness, though. He wasn't seeking to brag or be cool about this. And this is what I speak on in my campaign. We stop recycled crime. We stop those guys like Alpo that set up the youngin', that make it seem like he's thorough, he gonna be the only one that bail out a renegade, and then that renegade get attached to him, thinking he's solid, and follows everything he do, only to be lined up and put in prison also. These guys help recycle crime, and that's what Wayne Perry is trying to stop, and that's what I'm trying to stop. So when we get together, and how you gonna link it, This is a plan from a law superintendent with the ILA.
This a long time coming for you, homeboy. My man Ben told me that, like I said, I'm just not new. I don't do no reaching. I just ain't with all that shit. You know, I had everybody that's up there compete with you. I had all them reach to me, try to do this, try to do that. I ain't that. Pop told me to be a different type of dude. I do what I do, and I stay out the way, and I mind my business. And I'm Muslim, so I give everybody that respect, and that's it. You know what I'm saying? Who he was, he did what he do. I do what I do, and you know, I just hold it up in a different type of way. You know, that I ain't on the.
You get a chance to let him know before I even get a chance to let him know, right? That we had that cocksucker, that rat Alpo on the ropes. You hear me? Hey, listen, that's one for every good man worldwide. That chump and his red ass son, they stood outside of Queens Flip, who's a good person. And I'm telling you, you need to get on there because you don't have to speak of the negative part of things. You dig what I'm saying?
Right.
But
right.
Flip is a good dude because he's all for the positive things. So,
right.
Like a lot of this stuff is a long time coming, and I think this is a way for us to get your pop some air in a better way because we all know
that. Right.
Ain't no way on him coming home. You dig where I'm coming from? But we do have.
Oh, ain't no question. I look for it, but that ain't a thing that he bank on.
Yeah, but we look for the understanding, though, right? That every child, everyone that's out here that's claiming Wayne Perry on a negative vibe can switch their mindset and be at rest.
Yeah, way he switch it way up.
Right,
yeah.
That could be at rest. And
that's
like,
what he really want
to
do.
The killer of the killers are telling me to put my guns down. The killer of
that's
the killers.
That's what he really want
to
do, though.
You dig me?
Yeah.
So
him and Hoover, like, dudes probably look, you know, Chicago shit, D.C. shit. But them dudes that really originated shit, they on another level with life because they can see this shit for what it is for real. You know what I mean? They not closing their neighborhoods no more.
I met some good men from D.C. that were solid men, right? I got a brother by the name of Musa, a good dude, you know what I mean? Very solid. Umar, Abdul Wahid, couple brothers that was in the feds that was super solid that I want to say.
What feds you were
at? I was just about damn near everywhere, but my last run was at Farrington. That's where I kind of conversed and kicked it with a lot of people. The Mother Jones, I ain't really speak to too many dudes because, you know, the murder game was on and I don't like to brag on it, you know what I mean? But
ain't no question. Fair.
But I like to say this to everybody, and I like to say this to you, that the federal joints, penitentiaries, FCIs, all them joints taught me one thing, and that's keep your eyes and your ears open and keep your mouth shut.
Close, yeah, I know.
Walk them halls with your eye intact, with your chin up, no matter
if you're big, sad, or
married to whoever.
I don't know, like you say, all the junks you've been in, but if I just listen to how you talk, I just know that we ain't too far apart. If you from Philly, I'm from D.C., but I feel your vibe every time I listen to the shit, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, listen to
me. I feel your vibe and where you be coming from. Most motherfuckers that do that shit, they doing it as a joke.
Oh, they
you like games. About the men. And
if you notice, I stopped for so long.
Yeah, I know.
The reason why I stopped.
Because you see the bullshit in it, so you gotta make a mission.
They made it cartoonish. They made it too kittenish for me. You dig me? To where it's dope.
Right.
When I mention the joints I was in, when I stamp on that, they don't understand it. They don't see it. So what I start doing is being who I am. So now people can take the person that was in the prison, and now he's outside of that prison, and he's still giving it the same way. Any joint I was ever at, I gave a rat hell, and I kept him away from me. It didn't matter.
Oh, ain't no other way to be, man. Ain't no other way, man. That's what's wrong with the world today. Now, nigga ain't saying be violent, but, man, all that, you know, dude turned against the code of honor of man can't never be with that.
And it's crazy. You know what's crazy, man? You sound just like your pop. I heard.
I am him. I am. Watch when you cut out these
things. Hey, look, it's crazy because we was kicked when I was listening to one of his interviews, right?
And I put that out there. Wayne Perry Speaks. I put that out there. Nobody talking about me. I got all the recordings, man.
Hey, man, we going to have some fun.
We're going to do it. Let me call my man and tell him I'm talking to you and shit. Okay. But I told him, hey, I said, my man, because I've been texting you, right? And I don't do that shit. But I'm like, man, I'm going to get something to hit me. Fuck this shit. Because my man been telling me, like, man, get in contact with him. I think that'll do it. This, like, from last year, and I'm like, you know, I don't be doing that. She's like, cool, get in contact with him. Man, well, hey, I'm on the phone with Ernie now, cuz. Yeah, so he definitely said he sounded like your father. I was telling my man, we gotta connect up, man. I mean, if it gotta come up or we come down or however it gotta be, but you gotta get it together. I'm coming there soon. I got a good friend of mine that's from Baltimore. We was in a can together.
We've been in just about every joint together. He's solid guy, man, and I'm coming, man, because it's about time we have an honorable party, and it's about time your pop start getting the recognition that he. I don't want this to be something, you know. I talk and it's a vlog, and we don't do nothing else. Nah, we're gonna make sure OG tight, and we're gonna make sure that his voice is the voice for the streets.
I'm about to say you're gonna be. That's what I was about to say. You're gonna be a part of that voice of the streets for him, man.
Oh, yeah, he got to
get it. You know, he can put his own shit out, but I told my mom, I said, I got his son, because for real, like, especially I did yesterday, the other day when you put, I said, man, son will really make me all the way on his platform with him, man, like, however he needs the help, however he needs whatever little thing. You know what I'm saying? That's, you know, on for real shit, because I see where you coming from with. You ain't had to do that shit just to represent for another man of honor, like, that's principle. That ain't no sucker shit or nothing. I'm trying to. Grab no clout, none of that. Nah, that's principle shit. When you get up there and speak for a man that can't speak for himself, and you know he's honorable, like, that's the same thing I want a man to do for me.
Hey, listen to me, man. You know, it's in my heart. I got an uncle that's on death row. You know what I'm saying? And my uncle, he always speak good of him. And we, you know, we love him because we see that he is for the sake of the law. He ain't coming. He could be in that dungeon right now screaming and yelling, hate, hate, hate. He's not.
Nah, he don't do that.
Oh, my God. Yeah. And he's up there with a brother from my city by the name of Kabani Savage. They up there together.
What's his name? Kabani what?
Kabani Savage.
Kabani Savage,
all right. Yeah, Kabani got a rat lied on him, said he firebombed a house, claiming some kids was in there, man. Bond super solid, man. These dudes got some tapes that they didn't put the tapes in there. You know how they do their little record and pause and bring things up to speed. Got this man sitting on death row. He got an honorable son out here. I tried to hook him up with the other little youngins that's around, but, you know, everybody don't have the same demeanor and the same honor. I ran into a kid from New York who had the same demeanor, same honor as yours by the name of Fadeback. His father was Ferris Phillips. He was a guy that was from New York. He just come home. He's pop done about close to 30. You dig me? And he stayed with his dad, man, day for day. And one time I said something about his pop because some fake fraud was saying something negative on the gram. And I ran with it not knowing what I was doing. You know, we admit our problems and when we make a mistake. So I confronted him. He confronted me like, yo, get out of here. I ain't trying to hear that. You know what I mean? And my thing was, where that work at? And Kevin Childs vouched, put the work up. They both called me back. Fadeback apologized. And they sent me to work. To me, that's the most honorable thing outside of me getting this call from you. You hear me?
Right.
Because when I get good men that stand on principle, I don't have no problem with sharing this platform with them. This platform ain't no for no suckers. These guys don't like me out here. These guys hate me.
Because you be telling the truth. You be getting on that law. Like, this man shit. Don't get on that sucker shit.
Right.
Niggas don't like when they be called out for their sucker shit. They don't like that.
No, they hate it. So, through all the parade and through all of, you know, the nonsense, my thing is this to you, bro. I honor you. We're going to get together. We got to do some big things. We got to kick it.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be a part two.